All right, good morning. Welcome to Trophy Taker Outdoors and the Bartow Ford Outdoor Update. What's happening, guys?
Everything's great, man. Good morning.
What? Hunting season's in the air.
In the air, but you know what? We had just the Hurricane Michael come through. I wonder what that's going to do for all those hunters up there.
It's bad. I know a lot of my buddies have places up that in that area, in Georgia, North Florida, and they were all sweating it. And I feel bad for the people that live there, no doubt.
You just fished the United Way tournament down there. How was that? That was pretty awesome.
Silly. It's a blessing to get to fish a place like that, and it's kind of you get to go once or twice a year, but the fishing's just, I mean, it isn't fishing, it's catching.
Man. It's catching.
And it makes it fun.
I know.
I mean, when you look so, that, I mean, I look forward to going every time, but you look so forward to this because you know I'm going to get bites, I'm going to catch fish, and it makes it fun.
And you did it a couple of years in a row, haven't
yep.
you?
Yeah, it's about I think this weekend was my third or fourth time we've done that, and it's a good cause. The money goes the United Way, and the fishing's wonderful, and the people that run it really have their stuff together, and makes it nice.
Don't let him be humble. Ask him how he did.
How did you do, Mike?
We did all right. We didn't do bad.
Yeah, you guys did really good, you know, and caught some fish, and you capitalized on what you guys needed, and that's important.
You know, it's funny, but I fish a bunch, and everybody's got their strengths and weaknesses on fishing, you know, and the way they were biting is my A game. I mean, so
yeah.
It was funny, we're driving there, my son's telling me, Dad, you're gonna wreck them. They're biting just the way you love to catch them, and it was silly. So it just worked right into our strengths. I mean, heck, it was fun.
Well, Major League Fishing has basically created a tournament trail.
Yeah. The BPT.
Yes. And they're basically, I guess they're just exclusive to this tournament trail. So they've signed them.
80 people.
80 people, and these are elite guys. If you look at the list of these guys, you're talking major guys.
Oh no, they and I'm, don't get me wrong, there's still plenty of the guys that fish that will fill the spots for elite, and the guys that will fish FLW are still very talented anglers. A lot of good sticks on that tour, but this BPT took the best of the best from, I mean, FLW, and they really hit the elite series hard and brought these guys over to this BPT, and they're gonna, I mean, if you're gonna win one of those, you're going to beat the best of the best.
Oh, yeah. That's no doubt about it. You are not going to go there and just think that it's going to be easy.
No.
So, but, you know, I tell people all the time, I'm like, but what about the Bassmaster Classic? That's what I tell people. I mean, they say, well, you know, Major League Fishing, this is the new and greatest things. Hold a second. Growing up, what was my dream?
That was it.
Fishing the Bassmaster Classic.
Yep.
And that's what it's, the Bassmaster Classic will always be there. It will be that one Super Bowl of fishing.
Yep.
You know what I mean? Even though this Major League Fishing is, you know, a new and exciting trail, we still have the Bassmaster Classic. And another thing is, how about these guys out there that have the chance to do this now?
Exactly. They wouldn't have got that opportunity. Yep, and you know, and it's funny with the Classic, but like you said, growing up, it's the thing, but the beautiful thing about the Classic is it's you can take guys that aren't bass geeks like me and you, and they know what the Bassmaster Classic is. They watch the Classic.
Yes.
They know who won the Classic,
yes.
where you know, they may not just a regular Elite Series tournament on Lake Norman, but they will tell you, okay, these guys won the Classic, and it is going to be a different deal, but you know what, there'll be talented anglers to fill that spot. There'll be the next up-and-coming guys. I mean,
there will be. And and when they do that, all that's going to do is create more superstars in fishing.
Yep.
You know, because once they get that under their belt, that confidence, and we're talking about that confidence of having that under.
I think it's good for the sport.
It is. I think it is. You know, hypothetically, if you and I could have our choice to do that, what would you pick?
I wouldn't pick any of them. I wouldn't get my butt whooped that bad every time. You know what I mean? I mean.
But honestly, if we were that good.
If we were that, I mean, you'd have to think that the BPT and how way everything's going would be.
It's the new thing.
It's the new thing.
So let's talk a little bit of hunting.
A little bit. Dove season opened a couple weeks ago. I got out there first weekend, and we did really well. Didn't wood duck hunt. But we saw a lot of woodies where we were at. We were over there near Davenport area, mm-hmm. and I have to be careful because I can't give away Matt's spots. But
I know. I think I made that mistake one time.
One time, and he's never let you live it down. But we did see some woodies. I know some people that picked up some teal, and they had the second phase come through. Then we'll have to wait till our regular season opens. But I've seen some birds. I know we have cold front coming through this next weekend, so it may push some birds down. The dove were in volume out right now. But I think they're all resident birds, you know, they're kind of local birds. And we'll start seeing some northern birds push down maybe the middle of December. Now, they've stretched the season out. You know, they started back on the 22nd, I think it was. And remember how when we first opened it, it was always noon to dark?
Right.
They've opened it all day.
Oh,
so
nice.
So the first phase, you could hunt at daylight.
Oh, nice.
Which is nice because it's so flippin' hot.
I know.
You know, you don't have to sit out there in 100-degree weather. So they did open it up. I actually didn't go that morning. I waited until that afternoon because we had some other things going on. But we were able to shoot a couple limits, and it worked out really well.
Dove hunting, I've only done it a few times, but they say to shoot a bird is a box of
rounds. That depends.
Not if you shoot like Steve.
I know, right?
If you shoot like me, then yeah.
I've taken his brother before. His brother, I think he's probably a good shot as well. I've taken his brother before with me, and he shot really well. And it is a challenge. I think what it is, it's the warm up, because usually you've had the gun in the case all summer. You didn't shoot till last January, and it's the first time to get out. And nobody practices. They don't go out and shoot sporting clays like we do. But if you get out there cold, you're gonna shoot a few shells before you kind of get into the rhythm of it.
Well, the thing is, you're sitting there with a group of guys. You're sitting there talking, having conversations, and all of a sudden a dove comes in.
Bird,
and everybody's going crazy.
It's chaos.
It's chaos.
It is chaos. It is chaos.
I got him.
Argument.
This one field we were shooting on, it was adjacent to another field, and there were a bunch of guys in the other field. There was only about six of us in this field. But you'd hear boom, 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 and all of a sudden you see this lonely pair of doves trying to escape that group, and of course they fly right over our area. We had lots of cover and everything. So
Steve's area is a bad area for the doves.
It was a bad area for the doves.
I was
really fortunate. I had a couple of really good shots.
That is a danger zone.
I had a couple of long shots. I had a couple of doubles, and we were doing really well. Matt and I get started going, do you think we can shoot left-handed? I said, I don't know, let's try. So we were shooting a few left-handed. I'll send you the video of one of his, but the bird was safe.
I know, always trying new things when you're out there. But you know, Mike, you've been duck hunting.
Oh, yeah.
I love duck hunting because the part I love about duck hunting, we can have a conversation like we're having right now and not even worry about being quiet.
These whistling ducks are really easy birds to shoot. So if you want to rant, usually we're worried about ranting out.
Where did they come from?
Yeah,
from Mexico. You know, 10 years ago, I've never seen those.
They came from Mexico, South and Central America. They came up 25 years ago. I had some friends that were in Lake Placid, and they said, listen, I shot some birds, and I'm going to send you a picture of them. Would you tell me what they are? And I said, yeah. He said, well, they're all on this pond. He said, we jumped them, and we ended up shooting about six of them. He said, can we eat them? And I looked at him. I said, yeah, that's a black-bellied whistling duck.
They are. It's amazing that 5 years ago, I never seen one.
I know, right?
I sometimes will feed the birds out here at the ponds, and the mallards that we have around here are kind of resident mallards. They'll stay here most of the time. And the whistling ducks will come in. Sometimes I counted like 30 out there one day. I'll go out there and I'll whistle to them and I'll go and feed. They'll come up like pets. The mallards won't come up to me. They're very skittish and they'll stay off. The Florida mallards, there are Florida mallards here. The hen and the drake look the same. They look like a hen, but the beaks are slightly different.
Right.
But they're the same size as a greenhead. They fly just like a greenhead. But
they just have a different name tag.
Yeah, they do have. They have a little label.
Do you check the back of their jersey?
I do. They have a little tattoo right here.
Nice. Talking about, you said something about snook fishing. We're going to take a quick break. We're going to talk a little bit about the reds that's going on in Tampa Bay right now. So
good to me.
So stick with us, Trophy Taker Outdoors. All right, we're back. Trophy Taker Outdoors. We're here at Bartow Ford for the outdoor update. Let's talk a little bit about the red fishing that's going on in Tampa Bay. It is on fire right now.
Yep. One of our buddies got a report it on. They fished at a tournament Saturday, and the girl that won it caught 65 redfish in one day. So
wow.
I mean, this time of year is the time of year they'll school up. I mean, and the thing about this, when you catch one this time of year, you're typically getting started. That's where they're at.
Yeah.
So.
And it's funny because you and I talked a little bit. I've been in those flats where you'll see 100 and another 100 come through, and it's just a big circle of redfish coming through. The problem is people don't know how to fish those fish, and they just jump right in the middle of them, scatter them, and then it's all gone.
It's a shame, but I mean,
you just have to, it's education. It's education, you know. People just need to understand, you know. They see all these fish. Sometimes they don't even know what it is.
Yep.
You know, but
right.
you know, if you approach it, you know, correctly, you can catch a bunch of fish.
Oh, big time.
You know?
Everybody can.
Yes.
Yeah, and you can, we've had it where there's three or four boats and you're ping-ponging them back and forth from boat to boat, and you know, you'll catch one and the school will bounce back over to me, and I'll catch one and then they'll bounce back over to you, and you sit there and you just have you sit there for an hour, 2 hours and catching them if everybody's doing the right thing.
You're a big snook fisherman, and this time of year we're catching a bunch of small ones. You'll catch a ton of them.
A bunch.
What can you do to catch that bigger? What are you doing to catch a little bit bigger fish, and where are you fishing? Because typically around those islands is where we're catching all those little ones.
Yeah, I mean, everybody likes beating the bushes, and that's where a lot of your little ones are. Your bigger ones sometimes are a little bit off that, in some of the potholes. A lot of people don't know this, but snook they'll eat a cut bait in a heartbeat. I mean, they will eat a half of a pinfish laid on the bottom, especially a big one. A big snook's a lazy animal. He's not going to go chasing on greenback all the way around all the time. I mean, don't get me wrong. You'll still catch him on that. But sometimes, I mean, I know two or three people, the biggest snook they've ever caught has been on cut bait laid on the bottom. You know, your bridges, your docks, stuff like that. That's where a lot of those giants hang out. I mean, your flats are typically loaded with those, whatever it calls, chickens and all that. But some of your other places, your little bit deeper places, or where some of those big giants hang out. If you're looking for big ones.
It's doing really well. We got fall right here. It's going to happen. We got this cold front coming through, so I think good things are going to happen in fishing. So you guys stay tuned. You guys go to trophytakeroutdoors.com to get more information about any of the stuff we're talking about right now. And let's talk a little bit about Bartow Ford and what you guys have coming up. I mean, you got Winter Wonderland coming up. You've got, I mean, just toys, the toy drive.
Yep.
Just talk about the toy drive real quick.
That's something we've done every year. We put a truck on the showroom. We try to fill the truck bed up with as many toys as we can. A lot of our employees get involved. We're blessed. We've got 275 employees, and so many of them are thoughtful, good people that help us out. I mean, the last few years, we've been able to fill that truck completely up. And a lot of times what we'll do at the end, we'll match what we've got. So we'll go down and spend money and buy, you know, even more stuff. So if we got a one truck load, we usually end up being able to donate a couple.
And we get people that aren't able to go shopping and, but they like what we do.
Right.
And they'll bring us a check and they'll say, listen, we want to give you $100 or $50 or $20 or whatever it is. And we'll utilize those funds to supplement what we've done already.
And believe it or not, we got some girls here that are couponers.
Oh,
so
really?
They
oh
make our money last, and we're able to, the amount of families we've touched on that has been amazing, and that's it's a neat thing we do, because you get to see these people that may not be able to get their kid that bicycle this year, or the skateboard, or whatever it is, and we're able to help with that with these kids and make Christmas something they remember and good light.
Absolutely. So you guys can come to Bartow Ford and donate a toy, put it in the back of the truck for them. They really appreciate it. You guys, I heard last year the kids just lit up when you guys took
it. And I can promise everybody, our toys, our stuff that we get, go to the needy people who deserve them. And we're picky about that, and it's a great deal.
Absolutely. So make sure you guys do that. Also, what do you guys got going on for trucks and cars and a bunch of stuff going on, huh?
Yeah, it's closeout for the 18th. So
you
got a lot of, you know, you're get some great deals on some of that. The 150s right now, the F-150 series, the incentives, you got 0 for 72.
Wow.
Some of the XLTs have got over $6,000 in rebates. So, I mean, there's, anytime you know the model you're closeout, Ford's pushing. So there's a lot of good, I mean, F-series.
This is the time of the year where you want to get a truck and get those good deals. And you guys have a ton of trucks out there for them. So.
I took extra allocation. We actually took about an extra 218 F-150s because we're like, hey, we know this is a good opportunity for us. Ford's going to maintain truck leadership. Ford's been the leader for, you know, 33 years in a row, the number one, you know, truck brand. They're not going to give that up. So they don't care what they have to do, what they have to put on it. They're going to sell those trucks. So us, to be able to get the amount and have customers be able to get a great deal and get a truck they want. Because a lot of times what happens at the end of the year, your selection goes down. So, you know, you might not be able to come in here and say, hey, I got to have that blue one with the tan interior with this and that.
Right.
But the earlier you come in and get it, the better chance you got to get the exact truck you're looking for.
Well, several things happen. One, we know we have experience being a commercial dealership too, that a lot of businesses look at their end of their third quarter and they go, hey, I got to spend a little bit of money. This year's been very good for a lot of businesses.
Right.
It's been a very, very good year. So a lot of guys are going to come in and say, I need to spend $200,000 or $100,000 or $300,000 or whatever it might be, and they would rather upgrade their fleet than pay taxes on that,
exactly,
that full amount. So they'll come in. Mike anticipates that, so he also orders commercial trucks, you know, the XLs, the work truck series as well to supplement it. We've got 3 to 5 trailer loads a day unloading out there. His son helps process that, so he's running around like a madman every day. But I mean, every single day, including Saturdays, we have trucks bringing tractor trailers bringing trucks and inventory to us. So it's made a big difference, because it's nice to be able to go out there and have a selection.
Right.
You go to some dealerships and you'll see they've got 6 trucks and 7 cars, or they got 20 trucks, but they only have 3 Super Duties. They got no dualies. You come here, you're going to see a Raptor, you're going to see a dually, you're going to see a work truck, you're going to see a high-end Platinum. You'll see a loaded 450 pickup. You know, those things are available here.
Is it true they have the Ranger coming back?
Ranger's coming back.
Wow. 19.
Yep,
yeah.
19. It's going to be exciting. We're looking at getting them probably Christmas, New Year time. But I'm going to tell you, I've been with Ford now 20 years, and the excitement, other than the Bronco, because everybody's talking about the Bronco, which will be next year. But the Ranger, it's amazing how many people are coming in, just cannot wait on that.
I mean that's going to be a huge, huge vehicle.
It is. And it's, you know, back in the day when I was here, you know, we sold Rangers. The other months, we sell 30, 40 Rangers. So it was a popular segment. And I think even now that it's going to be a crew cab, it's going to be a little nicer truck. It's going to have the EcoBoost motor in it, which is awesome.
Man,
so
great.
It's going to rip, and I think that it's going to be extremely popular.
Yeah.
It's a need for a lot of people, because a lot of people don't necessarily have to have a truck that's going to go and pull 12,000 pounds. They don't have to have a truck that seats 14 people. So for the customer that goes to Lowe's, goes to Home Depot, gets 14 bags of sod or mulch or something, I mean, it's perfect. And
you can still put a couple people in the back if
absolutely.
You want to go out to dinner or something.
Yep. And it's going to, and with the EcoBoost, you're probably looking at a truck that combined, you know, estimated mileage is going to be in the high 20s.
It's going to be a game changer.
It is going to be
really will be.
For us, especially us being a truck store, it's going to be great for us.
Absolutely. So BartowFord.com, check out their inventory here. Give Steve a call or Mike a call.
Come by. Yeah, just come by and say
hi. Hang on. As a matter of fact, if you come in right now, we got hunting on TV back there.
Exactly.
Everybody's blood's getting flowing. You know, this is the time of year all my buddies send me all the game camera pics. People are starting to, you know, every once in a while somebody will shoot a nice buck because, you know, the seasons are opening in a lot of places. So this is everybody gets the hunting fever around Bartow Ford right now.
I know. Oh, yeah. It's getting there, and I'm excited. I can't wait.
Too.
I'm counting the days. So. Yeah. Well, I appreciate it, guys. Hey, we appreciate you guys listening and watching Trophy Taker Outdoors for the Bartow Ford Outdoor Update. You can go to BartowFord.com for check out their inventory. You can go to TrophyTakerOutdoors.com for more information on any of the stuff we're talking about here today. We'll see you guys. God bless. Fishing a camo.